Welcome back to CS11. This is lecture number 3, part B, arithmetic, roughly corresponding to section 2.2 from the textbook. Okay, so let's talk about doing arithmetic in programming. First of all, for basic arithmetic, we've got four operators, addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, which use the asterisk and the forward slash. Also, the percent sign for modulus, which we'll talk about, which I don't think you'll see in Chapter 2. We have this for basic arithmetic. It does have algebraic precedence, so multiplication and division happen first. Otherwise, your equation is generally evaluated from left to right. So, for example, if we write 5 plus 4 minus 3, we would evaluate the plus first and then the minus. But if we write 5 plus 4 times 3, then the multiplication has higher precedence, and 4 times 3 is 12, and then we add 5 is 17. Just like in algebra, we can use parentheses to force groupings. So now, here we would get 5 plus 4 is 9 times 3 is 27. So, basic arithmetic, and let me show you a quick example of that. So let's write a program here. Let's file, save as, and I'll call this lecture3b.cpp. Okay, pound include iostream using namespace standard main. Oops. Return 0. And we can put a equation, or also known as an expression, any place that we could use an integer value. So, for example, that could be as part of an assignment statement, or even part of the declaration of a variable. Or it could be part of a cout command. We can output integer values. So here, why don't we output 6 divided by 5. All right, I'm going to go ahead and save that. And let's run this after we compile it. Tick. Lecture 3B, and oh, interesting, look, it gave me here a warning, unused variable result, because I created this variable and even gave it a value but then never used it. Some compilers will give you that warning, and some won't. And notice that was only a warning, and warnings are cautions that there may be a problem with your program, but they're not an error, so it didn't prevent the program from compiling, so I can go ahead and still he'll run it, and here you can see that 6 divided by 5 is 1. And that might be surprising if you expected that it was going to be 1.2, but if we take a look at it, notice here that we have 6 divided by 5, and both 6 and 5 are integers. And previously we talked a little bit about the types in C++. And those types carry over to the arithmetic. And so both 6 and 5 are integers. And so that means that that division operation that's going to happen is going to be also an integer division. And if you do integer arithmetic, you can only get integer results. And so that's why we see 1 there. Now, let's add one more line here, and let's say 6 modulus 5. So the percent sign, which I don't think is called out in chapter 2, is gives you the remainder of integer division. So it's called modulus. And we'll be making use of this operator quite a bit later in the semester. And so here, let's go ahead and save, and let's compile that. And run, and notice we get 1 and 1. Now if we pick a different value here, let's say 7 divided by 5, and 7 modulus 5, let's recompile and run. And notice 5 goes into 7 one time, and remainder is 2, and so we can see that. Now, if either one or both of these values here had been a double, such as 7.1, then we'll get a different result here. So let's go ahead and comment that line out. We don't need it. Comment that line out because I'm tired of seeing that warning. And let's go ahead and compile and run the program. And notice now we see 1.42. Now, this is a double. Here, 7.1, a value with a fractional component, and this here is an integer, and the computer can't do arithmetic with one double and one integer, so it has to promote that integer to a double, because it can only do arithmetic with either all integers or all doubles. So even if this had been 7.0, that would have been enough to force it to be a floating point or double calculation as opposed to a integer one. All right, now let's talk about another interesting value. Let's go ahead and put that in, and so the compiler won't complain. Let's see out result. And compile the program and run it, and we get a 6. Let me show you a nice operator known as the increment operator. And write result plus plus. And that's shorthand that says add 1 to that result variable. Because adding 1 happens so frequently, there's this nice shortcut for it. And then after we do that, we can print out the value again, and we'll see that its value has increased by 1. So there you can see it was 6, and after that assignment, it is 7. There's also a corresponding minus minus operator that subtracts 1. All right, now let's do just a little bit more arithmetic, and let me talk a little bit about the math library. So we've pound included IOStream in every program, and so let's talk about another include, and that is the CMath library. And in the CMath library are various functions, some trigonometric functions, so if you want to calculate sines and cosines and so on. There's a square root function, and there's a power function if you need to raise something to a particular exponent. All of those functions are built in there. So, for example, here, if we said cout, let's cout the square root of 91.0, and when we go to compile this program, we'll get an error, and it says square root. I don't know what that is. So here, if we include the CMath library and compile the program again, this time no error, and we run the program, and there's our result, 9.53939. So here it's showing us what the square root of 91 is. And there are several useful functions in the CMath library, and you can read about them in the textbook. Also, another good way to find out about libraries, if you know the name of the library and want to see what functions it is be to look it up on the internet. And so a good tip to use is when you're Googling or using some other search engine to find out about C++, to always use the keyword C++ along with the name of the library. and you should be able to easily find a reference that way. Okay, well, that's it for a very brief tour of computer arithmetic, and of course, we'll be doing a lot more arithmetic throughout the semester.